فإنه من يعش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا، فعليكم بسنتي ما تنشئون حزبا.
You have people in Trinidad that have turned up from nowhere. And you sit with them and you don't refer back to your elders that have been teaching in this land for over, what? How long? 10 years. Where's Imran gone? How many years has he been teaching? Longer? Same period, let's say 10, 15 years. Someone comes in here, you don't ask them? We've been coming here for 10 years. You don't ask us? You don't say, Ya Aba Khadij, Ya Aba Hakim, Ya Aba Idris, Ya Imran, Ya Amran, Ya Fulan. You brothers have been doing da'wah here for 10 years, 12 years. Someone's turned up, shall we sit with him? He sounds nice. He said he loves Al-Albani. Said he loves Bin Baz. Shall we sit with him? You not ask him? Mushkila ya ikhwan. This is where the problems begin. You don't go to your elders. You don't go to those who are more experienced. You don't ask the right questions. You're deceived. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived by the fact that a person has memorized such and such. That's not enough. Where's the years upon the da'wah? Where's the clarification of the da'wah? When Ihya al-Turaf al-Islami came to Medina University, when Abu Hakim was in Medina in those days, I remember visiting him in about 1997. And I went to see him perform the Hajj. And Abu Hakim was a student at the Islamic University then. I think he started the university in 94 or 95. 94 maybe. So I visited him either 96 or 97. I was sitting with him. I said, Abu Hakim, what's happening? Because we're hearing some speech that some of the Kuwaitis, that there's an organization in Kuwait and he's coming to give money to the students to join their organization. Or at least to bring them closer to themselves. He said, yes, there is. Jam'iyyat Ihya al-Turaq al-Islami, and their leader is Abdul Rahman Abdul Khaliq. He said, Alhamdulillah, we went to see Sheikh Rabia. Then we went to see Sheikh Ubayd al-Jabir. And we went to see Muhammad ibn Hadi al-Madkhali. 97 this was. 97. All of them without exception, they said, do not take a penny from this organization. Even if they claim, because Abdul Rahman al Khaliq was claiming, what? That he's a graduate from Islamic University of Medina. Graduate! Not only a graduate, a master's and a PhD. Studied with the best of the scholars, Abdul Rahman al Khaliq. Yaqub bin Shaybah, here's another one for you. Abdul Rahman al Khaliq. Studied under Bin Baz. Studied under Ibn Uthaymeen. Studied under Sheikh al-Albani. Studied under Muhammad Adin Shaqiqi, Sahib Adwal Bayan. The author of the Tafsir of the Qur'an in 9 volumes or 8 volumes. Beautiful, large volumes. Adwal Bayan, he studied under him. And he went to Kuwait, he's Egyptian originally, went to Kuwait and they brought him into the organization. Then he started speaking with the speech of Hassan al-Banna and those people. But he still said, look, I'm a student of Bin Baz. In fact, in those days, Bin Baz used to praise him. It was only a little bit later that Sheikh Bin Baz refuted him. He said, look, I'm a student of Bin Baz, I've graduated from Islamic University, I've got a master's, I've got a PhD. And he was older in age. Sheikh Al-Albani used to say about him, he used to be my student. Anyone here can say that? That Al-Albani said about you that you're his student? Sheikh Al-Albani said, he was my student. He came to me as an Ikhwani, he became my student, and we made him into a Salafi. Then, alas, he deviated again. But he came and they came with dananir, millions of them, into the whole of the kingdom of Saudi Arabia. They went to Sheikh Muqbil as well. They said, look, you're living in a dump, mud huts in Yemen. We'll replace all of this, ACs, marble, everything that you want, libraries, everything. Sheikh Muqbil said to him, take your Kuwaiti dinar and get out of here. We don't need your money. We don't need Ahl Sunnah. Do not seek isti'ana from Ahl al-Bid'ah. We don't seek help from Ahl al-Bid'ah. So the Salafi students, they didn't take the money. Who took the money in Medina? Abu Usama. Goldie. As Ahmed, Abu Awais Ahmed, Abdullah Ali mentioned, rahimahullah. He took money. Yasir Qadi. Tawfiq Chowdhury. These were people, money. Where do I sign? What do I don't have to read it. Just tell me where do I sign. money, dunya. Wallahi, we don't. When they came to Imam Ahmed, they said to Imam Ahmed, Ya Abu Abdullah, you see, you would accept help from the Jews and the Christians, but you would not help, accept help from Ahlul Bid'ah. He said, Ya Bunaya, my son, Ahlul Bid'ah will deceive you. The open kafir, the open disbeliever, he will not deceive you. You will not be deceived by him. We don't take money. We don't want their money. Barakallahu feekum. Sheikh Muqbil didn't take a penny. You know, the BBC, after Sheikh Muqbil died, the BBC said, a man has died in Yemen. BBC know him. In Britain, they said, a man has died in Yemen. And they said, at the low end of the estimates, he converted 1 million people to Salafiyah. Without ever asking for a penny from the people. It is not money that brings the hearts. In fact, if you read what Shaykh al-Fawzan mentions in Al-Ha'iyya, in Ishar Mandumat al-Ha'iyya, Shaykh Fawzan says that when you start taking money from them, this is what causes division in the heart. We don't take money from Ahlul Bid'ah. We don't need the help of Ahlul Bid'ah. We don't want Ikhwanis paying our wages and paying our money. This is not from the manhaj of the Salaf. They used to run from this. Look what Imam Ahmed said. Yes, I would seek help from the Jews and the Christians, but not from Ahlul Bid'ah. Because they will deceive you. Look at Abdurrahman the Khaliq when they went to Sheikh Rabi. This is a man who graduated. He's in charge of a huge... We don't want your money. Sheikh Rabi said, don't touch his money. We are not in need of it. Because when you take the money, then you have to start following their conditions. Don't speak about us. Don't clarify things. Just speak about general affairs of deen. Hellfire, paradise, how to make wudu. This is seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, mashallah, when he was upon the hijrah, how hard it was from one place to another. Allah, be happy with this. Anwar Awlaki was teaching that in almost every masjid in America. Then he came with his bid'ah. Even in the United Kingdom, wallahi, there was nothing that the people had upon Anwar Awlaki. They said, you people, why are you refuting Anwar Awlaki? This was before his, when he came out openly with his takfir and his khuruj and his bid'ah. They said, why do you at Maktab al-Salafiyya refute Anwar Awlaki? We said, because his companionship is Ahlul Bid'ah. That's enough for us. They said, have you heard his seerah? I said, no, and I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. Just like if you gave me the Muslims of Ya'qub, anyway, it's last. But even if you brought it, I don't want to read it. I'm not interested in the books of Ali al-Halabi or Abu al-Hasan al-Ma'arabi or Yahya al-Hajuri. I'm not interested in their books. Ahlul Sunnah will suffice. Ahlul Sunnah, our Imam suffices. Fawzan is sufficient. Rabi is sufficient. Ubayd is sufficient. Muhammad bin Adi is sufficient. Ahmed al-Najmi, Zayd al-Madkhali, Muqbil bin Hadi, Albani bin Baz al-Mutaymin. They're sufficient for our era and the likes of them. So be careful, brothers. You are eager in seeking knowledge, but don't let that eagerness make you go overboard. You know who the Salafi elders are in this country, and I've named them. And our brother Idu, and Amran and Imran, and our brothers, not to say that Muhideen publications that they give, that they themselves give da'wah, no, but they facilitate for others. For years, not to say that anyone is not free of mistakes, people make mistakes. But recognize the mistake, rectify. We have made mistakes and we rectify. You make mistakes and you rectify. This is the way of Ahlul Haqq. And when the truth comes, they accept the truth. So be careful from whom you take your knowledge. You have durus in Shaghanas. You have durus by our brother Idu here. Attend them. You have durus by our brother Imran in Masjid Shaghanas also. Attend them. They teach Arabic. They teach Quran. If you think that you're too, well, it's not on my level. I want to go higher than that. Go higher than that. Then go online and listen to Miraf. If you got Arabic, listen to Miraf Radio. And you will listen to Sheikh Rabi. You will listen to Sheikh Ubay. You will listen to Muhammad ibn Had. You will listen to the Mashaykh of Medina. Go to Sheikh Al-Fawzan's website and you listen to the live durus. If you believe that this is not enough. If you believe that, which you shouldn't anyway. And even if you do, then you still attend because these are your brothers. Barakallahu feekum. And we increase our ranks and we increase our numbers. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa jazakumullahu khairan.